हेलो, आई एम राहुल कुमार गुप्ता, फोर्थ ईयर सिविल इंजीनियरिंग स्टूडेंट एंड आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्क्राइब अबाउट द इमेज कैप्शनिंग। सो दिस इज़ द ब्रीफ प्रेजेंटेशन ओवरव्यू। आई विल ग्रो थ्रू द फॉलोइंग टॉपिक्स वन बाय वन। सो कमिंग टू द फर्स्ट थिंग, द प्रॉब्लम डेफिनेशन। सो आई एम वर्किंग ऑन द कैप्शन जनरेशन प्रोसेस। सो बेसिकली कैप्शन जनरेशन इन्वॉल्व्स जनरेटिंग अ टेक्सचुअल डिस्क्रिप्शन फॉर एन इमेज। That given an image, you can interpret the image and give a sequence of words or textual description of that image. So basically two major steps are involved in this process. The first step is the extraction of image features using computer vision steps. First you will go through the image, apply filters and get all the feature vectors in that image. And second process is the usage of natural language processing to turn that image understanding into words in a correct sequence so as to generate a caption. So what is the role of image captioning? So image captioning is playing a variety of role in today's era. So it is widely used across social media platforms to generate a caption for an image. Also it is used in automatic image captioning and to communicate the background story of photos. It can be used. So coming to the data set used, so I have used a Flickr 8K data set that contains about 8000 photographs in JPEG format, and then it has a text file that contains about 5 descriptions for each photos so that I can train it on that data set. So this data set has a predefined training data set about 6000 images, a development data set of about 1000 images, and finally a test data of 1000 images. So this is the reference that you can go through where I have taken this data set. So I have gone through this paper and finally chosen this data set to be used. We can use other data set also like Flickr 30K or MS Coco, but those are big data sets that can be used only with greater computing power. So as to have a smaller database and work on a laptop, I've chosen particularly this data set. So coming to the methodology, so basically there are 6 steps in that process for generating the image caption. So first step is preparing the photo data. So what I have to do is we have to extract the features out of the photo. So that step goes as the photo data preparation step. Next we have to prepare the text data so as to remove stop words or lemmatization or remove the punctuation and all. We have to prepare the text data. We have to reduce the vocabulary size as much as possible. So that will be our second step. Coming to the third step, we have to define our deep learning model. What are the various layers in that? Dropout we have to add. We have to add various connections and all. That will go in the third step. That is developing the deep learning model. Fourth step is fitting the model. So finally, we will fit it on our training data set, and then in the fifth step, we will evaluate the model. So we will use a loss function called the Bliss code that I will go in the further slides at what it is basically, and then we will finally compare the loss, and then we finally use it to generate the new captions on the best results which we got, and we will use that to generate new captions. So coming to the pre-processing part, so what we have used is the pre-trained model VGG16 to interpret the content of the photos. So we are not going here in developing a new training model, but we are using the existing VGG model to interpret the content of our photos. So this can be provided by Keras directly, so we have used that in our image captioning process. So what we are doing is that we are pre-computing all the photo features. That going through each photo while evaluating a model is difficult. So what we will do is that we will pre-compute the image features in particular, and then that we will save into a PKL file. So then we can load it anytime we want, and this will make our model faster and consume less memory, as we don't have to go through that large model each time we want to do anything with the photo. So we can use that as a pre-computation process to have all the extracted features at once. And then what we will do that VGA 16 is a series of layers and all. So what we will do here is that we will remove the last layer, because what VGG model basically does is that it classifies the image, but we don't want to classify the image into the 10 categories or 1000 categories. But what we basically want is that we want the feature representation of the photo, that what features are present in the photo. So for that purpose, we will remove the last layer. And so finally, we will get a one dimensional of about 4096 element vector as a result of this model. And that we will store in the features.pkl file, or any name we can give it to, and that we will store in the file for later use. So this is the VGG 16 architecture. So basically, black rectangles are the convolutional layers, the red rectangles are the max scrolling layers. And then we finally go some fully dense layers, that is, and we will use the rectified linear unit activation function there. And finally, for the output, we will use the softmax function to generate an output that gives the probability distributions or a one hot encoded version of the feature of the classification. But we will remove the softmax layer because we want only the feature representation vector, not the classification of the image. Coming to the text pre-processing part, so what we are doing here is that we have to reduce the vocabulary size, because the vocabulary is very large. If we take all the words in the description, then we will run into thousands of words. But what we want is to retain only the important words in the process. We don't want extra words. So to reduce the vocabulary size, we have to pre-process the image descriptions given in the txt file. So what basically we will be doing here is that we will convert all words to lowercase, so that lowercase and uppercase words are not treated differently. Then we will remove punctuations, which are of no use in our process in caption generation. Then we will use words with numbers or numbers, because those doesn't signify much, because if we want to represent 2, then we can basically say two instead of writing 2 as a number. So we will remove number, we will remove stop words, which are basically a and the, that can be removed for in our caption generation process, but that can be beneficial in a larger data set. But for now, we will remove the stop words also. And then what is the benefit of smaller vocabulary? So that our model can be trained faster if we have a smaller vocabulary. And then finally, what we got as a result we are showing here is the description.txt file is here. So this is the output. So corresponding to each file, we are getting the description of that file after pre-processing the text. So the number of descriptions are about 8092, and the vocabulary size which we got is about 7000 words as a result of this. Next process is developing the model. So now we are going to load our prepared photo, that is the features.pkl file and the text data, that we have cleaned all the text, and then we load both the photo and the text data for fitting the model. So now we are going to train the data on all of the photo and captions in the training data set, and then we will monitor performance on the development data set. And the best result which we got with the most accurate model, we will save it in a .h5 file so that it can be used later for the prediction. So what we are doing here is that we are for generating the caption, we are generating one word at a time, and then what we are doing is that the sequence of previously generated words are given as input for the generation of the next word. So for this process, we will need an initial word to start. And so what we are doing here is that we are using start as the initial word for kicking off the process, and end to signify the end of the caption generation process. So, and what we have also is we have to encode the text to numbers, because text cannot be interpreted as it is. We have to encode it to numbers. So that can be done using the Keras tokenizer class. I've used this to encode the text to the numbers before it can be presented to the model or compared to the model's predictions. Next comes is the developing model further. So what we are doing is that description is splitted into words. So we can use here the split function in the Python library to split each description into words by space. Then we will provide the model with one word and photo, and that the model will use to generate the next word. Then what we will do is combine the both words and the photo, and then we will give that input, that as input to the model further, that will generate another word. So we will continue this process of giving the sequence of generated words and the photo to generate the next word in the sequence. And later, when the model is used to generate descriptions, that is the captions, the generated words will be concatenated and recursively provided as input to the model to generate the final caption for an image. Here the input text is encoded as integers, so that will be fed to a word embedding layer, so that that and the photo features are fed directly to another part of the model. So the words are fed, the input text is fed to the word embedding layer, and the photos are fed to the another part of the model to generate the caption that you can see in this figure. So this is a brief representation that words are fed in the recurrent neural networks, that is the LSTM model, and the image are directly fed, and both are combined to generate the final caption. So what the model will output is a one hot encoded version of each word. So the model is divided into three parts. So first part is the photo feature extractor. So as I've already defined that this is a 16 layer VGG model that is pre-trained on the image net data set. So this will give the extracted features, which is a 256 element representation of the photo. Next is the sequence processor. So what the sequence processor does is that it expects input sequences, that we will give it a sequence of predefined length, that is we can fix it manually. I have chosen it to be 34 35, you can give it to. If the sequence is not of that particular length, that it will then it will be padded with appropriate spaces or empty words like that, and then that sequence is fed to an embedding layer that is using a mask, so as to ignore the padded values, and this is then fed into the LSTM layer, which has 256 memory units. And third part is the decoder. So what it does is that merges the vector from both the photo feature and the sequence processor using an addition operation, and then that is fed to a dense 256 neuron layer, and then we will get the final output dense layer that will make a softmax prediction over the entire vocabulary, that is the one hot encoded version. So we will get a final one hot encoded version of the word, that is the correct next word generated. So this is the brief model overview. So this part is the input layer one, that is the image part. So what we are getting here is the 4096 element vector representation. Then that is given to a dropout, so we are doing regularization by using the dropout. Then that is finally fenced to the dense layer that will give the 256 element representation. This part is the text representation. So what we are doing here is that we are giving a 34 word sequence. If not, then we will pad it appropriately so that it will be 34 words, and then finally it is given to a word embedding layer that will generate a 34 by 256 matrix, and then that will be given to a dropout so as to do some regularization to remove some inappropriate values, and then finally that is fed to a LSTM layer that will give the 256 element representation. So finally both these inputs are added here, and that will give an output of 256 elements. Then finally some dense connection over here will give the one hot encoded version of the word, that is the next generated word. So coming to the fitting and evaluation, so finally the model is trained on the image and caption data set, and best model we will save it in a file. So what we will do next is we will that evaluate each model on the holdout set. So suppose I'm training it for 20 epoch, So we will get 20 such files. So we will evaluate each of them on the holdout data set, that is the development data set or the test data set. And then what we will get is that finally the model with the most better performance and the lowest loss, we will use that to generate the new captions. So to evaluate a model, we will generate descriptions for all photos in the test data set, and then we will evaluate that with a cost function. So in this case, what we are using as a cost function is the Blue Score. So what Blue Score is basically is that it matches one by one words with the original description and the generated descriptions. If every word matches as it is, we will get a perfect score, that is one. If some words are missing or some words are different, then we will get a score somewhat in between. But a score closer to zero is worse, because that indicates that the original description and the generated descriptions are not matching at all. So basically, Blue Score summarizes that how close the generated text is to the expected set. So there are four types, or maybe you can elongate it further because it can go up to n or how many if you want. So what I have used is 1, 2, 3, and 4 cumulative rank. So 1 indicates that how many words are matching in the generated and the original description. 2 means that how many pairs of words in which are consecutive are same in the generated description and the original description. Same for 3, that how many consecutive 3 words are same in the original description and the generated description. So by this way, n grams can be calculated, that is the Blue Score. So what I've got as a result is that a Blue Score of 1, that is a 1 by 1 word matching, is about 50%. So about 50% generated word matches as in the original descriptions. And Blue 2 score is about 27%. So about 2 consecutive words are matching about 27%. Same for 3, about 18%, and 4, about 8.2%. So as it goes further, the length of the words, like four words in sequence, so we are getting the less accuracy here. So this loss indicates that about 50% generated words are same, which is a good result given that the model is trained only on 8,000 images. With more number of images, like in the Flickr 30K dataset where the images are about 30,000, we can get even better results. But for that, enough computation power, GPU, TPU computation power is needed for that purpose, because it consumes a lot of memory and processing power. Also, multiple word sequence loss results are good because it is about 20 to 30%, which is not that good, but compared to what we have trained with only few number of images, it is good enough. So finally, these are the image results. So here basically a cat is jumping on the grass, but what it has predicted is that the dog is running to the through the grass. So basically, it is classifying inappropriately a cat as a dog, but it has captured the grass and the running aspect of this picture, so quite good enough. Second thing is the two children are playing on the beach. So beach it has detected perfectly. Playing also, maybe if it can detect sand as well, then it would be even better. But two children is fine. Maybe a girl and a boy can be even better if it would have been detected, but two children is also comparatively fine. And then next comes is a dog is jumping into the water. So this is comparatively inaccurate, because dog is fine, but it is basically barking here, not jumping. Or a water, we can see it in the back, a little tinge of that. But basically, he is standing on a firm ground with sand or mud or something. So it is not that accurate, because it is neither jumping nor major portion of water is there. Basically, it would have been classified as barking, but fine with it. Next comes is that here what we have got the description as two men are playing soccer on field. So it has detected soccer properly. Men's are definitely not two, it is about five men's are here. So it is comparatively okay because at least soccer and field it has detected perfectly and two men also. Maybe it would have been better if it had detected all the persons in the image, but it is comparatively okay. So what we got as the final inference is that model was trained on a small data set, as we know, because I have basically the less computing power of laptop. Maybe I could have used Google Colab for that purpose, but finally I've decided to limit it to my laptop only. So the model is good enough but not accurate, as we can see in the results. It classifies some cats as dogs and failed to detect multiple persons in an image. Blaise score shows here is about 50% accuracy for word-to-word matching, but when I consider it as a sequence of words, then the accuracy is comparatively less, about 20%, so not very efficient. Here, what we have used is the small 16-layer VGG model for feature extraction. So, with larger model like Inception or ResNet with 152 layers, or with more number of layers comes, we have to go for more computing power. So here only 16-layer VGG model is used, so we can't do much about the feature extraction process. But with larger models which are trained on the ImageNet data set, we can definitely get a better performance on this. And then finally we can configure the model further, like tuning a dropout process, embedding process, LSTM. We can play with the LSTM layer and all, so as to get a better performance. And also we can use the words which are pre-trained on training data set, like Wikipedia or news articles, so much larger text base as compared to a smaller descriptions of about 8,000 vocabulary. That is not good enough, but if we get it trained on Wikipedia or big news articles, so it will definitely give a better performance than what we are getting now. So conclusions, my conclusion on that is that this model can be improved definitely with larger data set and with more computing power, and we can definitely get a better performance by using it on training it on Wikipedia or some news articles with larger corpus of text. And then we can do it further improvement. Can what image captioning, what basically does is that it relates to social media platforms, or you can go for that Flickr. If you click an image and you want it to get it automatic image captioning, then you can use this machine learning models, deep learning models. So this can help a lot on social media platforms, or even if you click an image on a mobile and want it to be get automatically image captioned or tagged, then that can be used. This model can be used for that purpose. So these are finally the references which I have gone through. So finally, with this, I in my presentation. Thank you.